Here is a wonderful, wonderful boat in which a young family can take over to Catalina or go cruising to Mexico. This boat is a Catalina 380, 1999. It's a 38-foot beauty. As you can see, this 38-foot Catalina has Dodger, dinghy, all canvas. It is in great shape. The canvas is in great shape, and all of the sails are in great shape. As you can see in this film, this is a Schaefer roller furling. Has a anchor, 35, with an electric windlass to, as you can imagine, wind it up, and an anchor area. Everything leads back to the cockpit. Has a boom brake and a Dodger with, as you can see, very, very comfortable seats. As we walk back into the cockpit, you can see the Dodger's in excellent shape with all excellent lines, with everything leading back to the cockpit. Coming into the cockpit area, you can see there is a comfortable chair for the helmsman, going around for a table for guests. Looking from the stern of the boat, you can see the Dodger going down in the gangway. There are seats and bags for all of the lines that are necessary to run the sails, and all of the sail lines come back to the center cockpit, to the cockpit area. You can see the auto helm and the Raytheon wind speed and wind direction. A wonderful feature, as you can see here, is a mast in which to put the radar dome on, and also serves as being able to pull the dinghy engine up and set it on the back of the boat when you're not using the engine. Goes down, hooks onto the engine, comes back up, and is located at the back of the boat where it is safe from any seas or losing it in the water. Now let's go down into the insides of the boat. As you can see, you come down a gangway into the galley area, which has a propane stove and power sink, dual sinks, and then goes off where there is a seating area into the salon, and then going forward into the forward area. After we leave the galley, the first place that I'd like to show you is the port side stateroom. As you can see, this is a beautiful aft stateroom. Large double bed, two seats in which you can sit and get ready for climbing into the bunk. Very roomy, just underneath the cockpit. Of course, what would a stateroom be like without having at least a television in which to watch a little TV while you're at anchor in your very spacious stateroom? Right off of the stateroom is the head. There are two doors. One door comes right off of the galley, and the other door comes right out of the stateroom. Now let's take a few moments to look at the engine. Looking down the engine on the port side, you'll be able to see that the starter, fuel pump, and water pump are all accessible to you. Then as you come around to the front of the engine, you'll see that the belts are available, along with the high output alternator, ready to supply you with all the voltage that you need. If we take a quick look at the bilge, we can see that it is in excellent shape and very, very clean. The engine is located underneath the steps, and as you'll see in a few moments, these steps move forward to allow you access into the engine. As an example, you can see the steps lean forward after they've been uncooked, and there you are, access, full access to the engine. Also in the back, there's a similar setup that the television is sitting on, which will also give you full access to the back of the engine and the transmission. In the work area where you bring the mud and sludge and seawater is a tile type floor. And then as we go into the salon, we have teak and holly floor. And as you can see, it's in lovely condition. There is no bad areas in it, even underneath the table and in front of the settees. The teak and holly is in perfect shape, right up, including the bow of the boat. As you can see in the galley, after you come down the gangway, the galley is to the port side, all the cabinets open up so you have full access to where you can put dishes, silverware, and you have a, as I said earlier, a propane stove. You have more storage underneath. You have a small refrigerator that allows you to keep things cool. And then you have a dual sink with electric pumps. As you can see now, we are looking at the navigation station, which has the electronics necessary to run the boat and the table in which to put your charts. Now we'll move on to the saloon, and as you can see, the settee is a U-shaped settee, and moving around you can see the table which allows you to have people there, and you can make into a bed. Moving forward through the salon, we can see that we're entering into the forward stateroom. There's a large double bed which allows two people to sleep here, with an area for cleaning and a sink area with storage underneath. And then as you move, you can see that there is an insert that can be taken out with more storage space underneath where the insert is. In the forward stateroom there on the starboard side, you can see there is a cedar lined closet for clothes and other accessories, plus a long hanging locker where it is also cedar lined. As we climb out of this wonderfully laid out 38 foot Catalina, you can see that it comes up into a beautifully appointed cockpit with all of the lines coming back from the sail. We have all the brakes in order to hold the lines with the winch. And then we have a table to enjoy drinks on while we're underway. And of course, we have another winch and more lines. Of course, what would a tour be without taking a look at the dinghy in order to get to shore while you're sitting at anchor in your cruising area? As you can see, it has a small two-stroke engine, and it is very well kept dinghy. It has a boarding ladder, and as I mentioned earlier, a lift in order to lift up the engine and put it on the boat. And of course, what sailboat would be without a barbecue? This is a boat that any sailor would love to have to go to Mexico, to the Caribbean, or just over to its namesake, Catalina.